3D printers can produce quite a lot of waste, especially if you're multicolor printing. Particularly, the very popular Bambu Lab printers purge out a ton of little filament poops every time you switch from one color to another, and this adds up. I recently printed a multicolor version of Zelda's Majora's Mask, and this print not only took 6 whole days, but it also purged 1.2 kilograms of material for a 500 gram print, which is kind of insane. The good thing is that I have a filament extruder, so can we recycle the poop into new, usable filament? Let's find out more! Guten Tag everybody, I'm Stefan and welcome to CNC Kitchen. This video is sponsored by Voxel PLA, which I exclusively use to print this beautiful model. On such long and big prints, you need a reliable and also affordable filament, and this is what Voxel PLA provides. Their Pro PLA, which comes in 12 different colors, sells for only $16.99 a spool and ships free within the US if you purchase 3 spools or more, with bulk discounts available for larger purchases. Voxel recently also expanded into selling high quality printer accessories with their enclosure kit for the Bambu Lab P1P. And what I like most, the Voxel Bento Box designed by Through the Frame. The Bento Box is a 2-stage HEPA and activated carbon filter that fits all Bambu Lab X and P series 3D printers, as well as the Voron Trident. It comes mostly assembled, so you can easily and quickly install it in your machine and reduce the emissions during printing. So if you live in the US and want to stock up on filament, or want a hassle-free air filter for your 3D printer, then go to voxelpla.com. I seriously have to admit, even though I do own a ton of filament right here, it always pains me if I have to throw away 3D prints or just waste filament. When printing regular parts, you can always consider if this print is something that you really need or if it will land in the trash very soon. Yet sometimes you don't really have an option. The most popular multicolor printers at the moment are Bambu Lab's XP and A series printers with their AMS unit. They use a so-called multiplexing system, where you have one tool head into which you can feed multiple, in Bambu Lab's case up to 16 different filaments for multicolor or even multi-material printing. The system is simple, reasonably cheap, and honestly one of the most reliable options on the market. But having a single nozzle through which you feed all of the different colors also comes with a problem. When switching between colors, you need to purge out a considerable amount of plastic before you get rid of the previous color. The Bambu Lab printers famously generate all of these purging poops that the printer spits out of its bag and which will considerably pile up after a while. Instead of throwing them in the trash, I wanted to use some of my collected filament poop and make new filament from it. I'm a bit lucky in this regard because 3Devo provided one of their filament extruders and shredders a while back, which I can use for this task. This equipment might not be in the price range for home users, but it's great to do a proof of concept. And if you're interested in seeing if this is also possible with more affordable equipment, make sure to be subscribed, because I bought the German-made Artme 3D DIY filament extruder that I'll be assembling and testing very soon. The filament poops themselves are too big to directly fit into the filament extruder, so I had to shred them first. This machine shears the plastic into small pieces that then collect in a tray at the bottom. Once I had a bunch of material chopped up, I quickly put it through a sieve in order to make sure that no big pieces still are in the ground-up material. As I already said in the beginning, this is not my first filament recycling project, but last time I had to learn the hard way that cleanliness is of utmost importance. Anything that's in the shredded material will later land in our filament. The multicolor print poop right here all used to be PLA filament, which has a rather low melting point. So when collecting the material, I really had to make sure to not have any purged material from polycarbonate prints in my pile, because these might render my material useless in the end. Another problem is foreign debris. Last time I had several clogged nozzles because metal particles somehow got into my recycled filament. To get at least magnetic particles out, I tossed a strong neodymium magnet into the box with all of the shredded material and moved everything around for a while, which should make steel particles adhere to the magnet, which I can later remove and then clean. But now to extrusion. I have the 3Devo Composer at my disposal, which is a very compact lab filament extruder. It's by far not cheap and certainly not the best option if you want to make filament at a large scale, but it gives me the option to play around with material extrusion without the need for a whole extrusion line. So I turned it on and waited until it heated up. Then I started flushing out all of the old material that still was in the extruder barrel. At some point, I added the transparent hopper and inserted this vibration spider. So, normal plastic pellets are round and flow without a problem in the hopper by themselves. Our regrinds, on the other hand, are very sharp and tend to interlock, consequently blocking the flow to the extruder screw. The vibrations help the particles flow and should result in a better extrusion result. The extruder itself is basically a big auger in a heated barrel that will slowly move the material from the feed zone all the way to the nozzle. On its way, it slowly melts, the air bubbles are pressed out, and it also gets thoroughly mixed. So unfortunately, we probably can't expect a rainbow colored filament coming out of the extruder, but rather a mix of all colors that we shredded. And what do we get if we mix all of these colors together? Yes, exactly, poop. Brown, which is kind of on theme if we remember that this used to be printer poop. I let another couple of meters of the new material extrude out, so everything had a bit of time to settle, and then started the spooling process. So working with shredded prints and print waste is always challenging, and I once again noticed that when just looking at how the diameter of the extruded filament varied. Such a professional extruder has a closed loop control system for filament diameter. The molten material comes out through a nozzle that's fairly larger than the 1.75 mm intended filament diameter. The right dimension is achieved by stretching the soft string, and the more you stretch it, the thinner it gets. So a diameter sensor measures the thickness, and an adjustable puller wheel stretches the filament. In theory, this should make sure that we stay within like around plus minus 0.05 millimeters of the filament diameter we want. Unfortunately, if the flow through the extruder is uneven, the system can't compensate quickly enough and we get either a too thin or a too thick filament diameter. And this is what unfortunately happened on my first batch. And we can't only see that on the graph, but also when we take a look at the filament itself after I pulled it out of the machine. Printing it went okay for a bit, until a thick section jammed the filament path and ruined the print. Even though the print itself looked okay until this point, I was clearly able to see sections of thicker and thinner filament on the part. Okay, so that's unsatisfying, but I had an idea to fix that. Years ago, I built myself a filament pelletizer that was still sitting in my basement. This machine chops down the filament into small pellets by feeding it through a drill-powered auger. I didn't have the old electronics anymore to power the stepper motor, so I simply connected it to my old Ender 3 that's running a duet board and has the mutant tool plate system installed. The idea here was that the more regular shapes of the chopped filament could be more consistently fed in the extruder, resulting in a better filament. It's an additional step, but also used in industry, and if it improves quality, it might be worthwhile. So I started the extruder for a second time, and after purging out the remains of the last extrusion, I started feeding our DIY filament pellets. At first, the result looked significantly more consistent. There weren't a lot of outliers. The roll of filament looked okay and still had the brown color from before. Also, the initial print results looked significantly better with less banding. Unfortunately, when I later came back to the print, I again only had half an owl and I got filament jammed in the extruder. Upon further inspection, by just running the filament through a bit of Bowden tube, I realized that I once again had blobs on the filament, which were way larger in diameter than the 1.75 millimeters that the material should have. Yet I couldn't give up. I wanted to succeed in converting multicolor printing poop into usable filament. At that point, I remembered that I had similar problems during extrusion in the past when the material just wasn't dry enough. Most of the purging poops I used for my first batch were from my PLA waste box that were able to absorb moisture for months. So for the second batch, I mostly used waste from very recent prints. To dry the material even further, I played around with vacuum drying, where the vacuum is an additional force to pull out any moisture out of the material. I tried pure vacuum drying in the past and had only medium success, so this time I stepped it up two notches. Not only did I add big bags of desiccant into the container, but I also put the evacuated pot on the bed of my GD X-Max 3, which was heated to 60 degrees Celsius, and regularly attached the chamber to a vacuum pump for 15 minutes. After a day, I shredded the material, put it again into the vacuum chamber for a night, and then started extrusion. The first interesting thing was that the color I ended up with on the filament had rather a greenish trash bag color instead of the brown from the first batch. That's simply due to the different colored materials that we used to mix together. I first thought I had to extrude a rough filament, pelletize it, and then extrude it again. Yet the second batch extruded very nice, with barely any variances out of the printable range. The melt itself also looked so much smoother without any bumps, and after around 1.5 hours, I had a second spool of filament made from recycled purge poop in my hand. And oh boy, did it look well! At first sight, I wasn't able to see any problems, so I went ahead and started the first print. Of course, with this greenish color, I could only print a Master Chief helmet. I had no hiccups at all and ended with a very nice and clean print. I could see tiny variances in the extrusion rate, but other than that, it seemed to be a well-usable material made from 100% 3D printing waste. Remarkable. After the first failed batch of material, I wouldn't have expected that the second one would turn out so well. It was another good lesson for me to work cleanly and with dry material, yet it also showed me what challenges are in trying to make recycled materials. Of course, if you consider the price of the machine and the manual labor, this is not something that's economical on a small scale, and even the environmental aspect is debatable looking at all of the mess at microplastics that I made. Yet I still think it was another great proof of concept to show that 100% recycled 3D printing filaments are possible. Not everyone can and should afford such a pricey lab filament extruder. Yet there are still alternatives like the Artme 3D or even my old Filostruder on the market that could make sense for a makerspace, even if it's only the challenge of getting a process like this working and not only looking at the money aspect. Fortunately, there are more and more 3D printing recycling companies popping up worldwide. We have the Recycling Fabrik in Germany, but there's also, for example, Printerior in the US that accepts scrap prints for recycling into filament. And you can't only recycle 3D printing waste into new filament. There are numerous examples where people use it for injection molding or seriously just melt it into a sheet and then machine it on a CNC. If you're interested in anything like this, then definitely also check out Precious Plastics and make sure that you separate your print waste into different types of polymers right from the start. And I'd love to hear your thoughts on recycling 3D printing waste. What are you doing with your failed prints? And would you buy recycled material, even if it sometimes wasn't as perfect as filament made from virgin material? Leave a comment down below. Thanks for watching, everyone. I hope you found this video interesting. If you want to support my work, head over to Patreon or become a YouTube member. Also, check out the other videos in my library. I hope to see you in the next one. Auf Wiedersehen and goodbye.